Welcome to Elevate Online. I'm Pastor Derek. I'm so glad you joined us tonight. It's Christmas time. And actually in the church calendar is this season called Advent, which is this important time in the church calendar where we look with anticipation to the celebration of Christmas and also the remembrance of the significance of that, and also looking towards the day when Jesus comes to redeem all things. And that's the season we're in. You can tell it's Christmas is all around us, right? And we're excited for this time. Want to let you know of some things going on here at Elevate. Just a reminder that Elevate's Christmas extravaganza is December 16th. This is during our Elevate Live. It's going to be during the regular time, 7 to 8 p.m. And it's always a great time. Grab your ugly Christmas sweater or just a pretty Christmas sweater. I don't care. Wear whatever sweater you want. And it's going to be from 7 to 8 p.m. during our regular Elevate time. And we'll also be giving out our Christmas gift that night as well. We won't be having Elevate on the 23rd of December or the 30th. That's for a week of Christmas, week of New Year's. But we will be back on January 6th. And so during those weeks, we won't have Elevate live or online, but we will be back on the 6th, okay? Just a reminder of some ways to stay informed. We still have that calendar info sheet that goes through the end of the year. Text Elevate Students to 31996 to be updated. And follow us on Instagram. And also, don't forget about elevateparents.org. All right?
Put that cookie down now!
Give up or you're thirsty for more?
Just wait and see this Christmas vacation. This old house sure is looking good. Got ourselves the finest snowman in the neighborhood.
Okay, people, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa!
Look, Daddy, teacher says every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings.
So if you had to pick, what would you say is your favorite Christmas movie? Or another question is, you know, does your family have that Christmas movie that you have to watch every year? It's just not Christmas if you don't watch that movie or not. Well, we are starting a new series called Christmas at the Movies, and we're going to be looking at different Christmas movies and how they relate to our relationship with God. And as we enter into this week and the movie we're going to be talking about, I have a question for you. Have you ever done something that you wish that you could forget? Or you wish everyone else would forget? Or maybe you hope that no one else would ever find out? Maybe it's something you've done, but people don't know yet, but you just are afraid someone will find out about it. Well, the Christmas movie we're going to be looking at tonight is something that the creator would like to forget. He would like everyone, and he just wishes everyone would just forget it ever existed. And he went to great lengths to try to make sure no one else would find out about its existence. The movie I'm referring to is not a holiday classic. It's not famous. It's really more infamous is probably a better word to describe it. And I doubt any of you have actually seen the whole thing or any of it. And many of you have probably never heard of it. And the movie I'm referring to is the Star Wars Holiday Special. Now, as many of you know, I'm a huge Star Wars geek, and I love just about everything Star Wars. I mean, the Mandalorian TV show right now, just perfect. It's such a good show. But this atrocity, it's something else. It came out in 1978 during the holiday season, and they were trying to capitalize on the monster success of the first Star Wars film that came out the year before in 1977. And it seemed like a no-brainer. They got the original cast back, and they added some other things, and just seemed like, of course, this is going to be successful. You mix Christmas, this holiday season, with Star Wars, of course it's going to be good. The problem was, it was terrible. Just absolutely terrible. And to give you a picture of how bad it was, here's part of, you may have seen, it's called Honest Trailers on YouTube. Well, part of the Honest Trailer shows you a little bit of the Star Wars Holiday Special.
Watch the original Star Wars trilogy lose its final shred of dignity in the Star Wars Holiday Special. A project so bad, George Lucas wanted it destroyed forever. And that guy made Attack of the Clones.
Wow. What do you know?
Sit through this vaguely Star Wars themed variety show, whether it's a song from Mos Eisley canteen owner B. Arthur,
just one more round, friend, then homeward bound, friend,
a song from 70s soft rock titans Jefferson Starship,
will you light the sky,
or a song from Princess Leia while Harrison Ford regrets all of his life choices. Now that's the face of a man who has a really bad feeling about this. In between the talent sections, enjoy a tiny scrap of story tying it all together, where Chewie has to get home to his beloved Itchy, Mala, and Lumpy for Life Day, which is like Christmas but hairy and vaguely Wiccan. The Empire is on high alert thanks to an overdubbed scene from A New Hope.
I want the rebels located and identified.
But with no help from Luke.
Where's Chewbacca?
No help from Leia.
Send either Chewbacca or Han Solo to the screen, please.
And actual help from one half of the Honeymooners, Art Carney.
I brought you that proton pack, you know, for the what's this? The thingamabob.
Chewie's family will spend over an hour horrifically groaning at each other while you try to maintain your last shred of sanity.
Kill me.
So melt your brain.
Wow. Yeah, I told you. And that was just the tip of the crappy iceberg. It was so bad. It was so bad that the Star Wars creator, George Lucas, who created Star Wars, who, in fairness to him, he didn't work on this project at all. Someone else did. You can kind of tell, right? But the creator of Star Wars never allowed it to be aired ever again. They had hoped that this would be like the next Charlie Brown special, but even bigger, you know, that airs every year. Well, except for this year, because it's on streaming. So actually, this is the first year. But anyways, he never allowed it to air again. And he ordered that all copies of it be destroyed. And he just never wanted anyone to ever see this again. He hated it that bad. But the problem was, is that people have a way of finding things that you don't want found. And people had recorded it when it aired originally. And I heard some stories of some illegal copies that were kept that weren't properly destroyed. And with the creation of the internet, of course, it has been shared all over the place. You can watch it on YouTube. And it's been making the rounds. When you have something that the creator once kept secret and put away, makes people want to watch it even more. You know, how George Lucas tried to handle this holiday special is often how we try to handle sin in our lives. We try to destroy it on our own, try to take care of it when it's too much for us. Or we try to just hide it from others, and even try to hide it from God. When you really think about it, that's a silly thing to try to do, but we do it all the time. Think about Adam and Eve in the garden. You know that story? They literally try to hide from God because they knew they had sinned. And we can often be like that. But sin has a way of coming out, no matter how hard we try to hide it. Just like this holiday special, it's not going to die. It's going to keep coming back. And sin, when we try to handle it on our own or just try to hide it, it has a way of coming out, has a way of destroying us. And the act of hiding it slowly eats at us. And it harms us more and more until we don't even recognize who we are. That's because we're never meant to handle it on our own. Because we can't. Sin is bigger than we can handle. But it's not bigger than God. It's not. And he wants us to trust him with it, to give it over to him, because he wants to help us. In Romans 10, 9 through 10, it says this. This is what he calls us to do with our sin. Instead of trying to hide it or trying to handle it on our own, trying to destroy it on our own, or just live with it, he says this. If you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by believing in your heart that you are made right with God. And it is by openly declaring your faith that you are saved. In 1 John 1, 9, it says this. If we confess our sins, we share it to God. Say, God, I'm sorry. Forgive me. He is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. This is what God calls us to do with our sin. We're called to give it over to him. To say, forgive me for this. Don't try to hide it. Don't try to take care of it on your own. Give it over to him. And we say, I believe in you. I believe in who you are. I believe and I trust you. I want to live for you. I want to be in relationship with you. That's the hope that he offers us. Not the destruction of trying to hide it or trying to deal with it on our own. And this is what God does with our sins. In Psalms 103, verse 12, he says, he has removed our sins as far as the east is from the west. That's how far. East and west never meet, right? And that is how far he removes the sin from us. Micah 7:19 says, once again, you have compassion on us. You will trample our sins under your feet and throw them in the depths of the ocean. He throws in the ocean floor. There's a great song by Audrey Adrenaline about that. Just far away from us. And think about Micah. This is from the Old Testament. When they're writing this, the ocean floor was completely unapproachable. And actually, still to this day, we have never been all the way to the lowest point of the ocean floor. Even with all of our technology, think about that. We've never been at the lowest of human being, actually physically in the lowest point of the ocean floor. That's how far away our sin is from us. The east is from the west, the ocean floor. He removes it completely from us. If we just trust him and truly give it over to him and say, God, I believe in you and I need your help. And then something really cool happens in us. It says this in 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old is gone. The new is here. So you are not defined by your past. You're not defined by your old sins. God is creating something new in you. You are a new creation. There's this saying that goes around sometimes, says, I'm just a sinner saved by grace. And I get what that means, but really it's not very accurate because you're actually a new creation in him. You're more and more every day becoming who God has created you to be. You are not defined by your past sins. You are a new creation. The old is gone. You're becoming more and more who you were always created to be. And that's what God wants to offer us. Not to try to hide sin, not to try to deal with it on our own, because it's going to destroy us. It's going to come to light. It's going to hurt those around us, and it's going to hurt ourselves. God says, give it over to me. Confess them. And say, God, I'm so sorry. I trust you. I want to be in relationship with you. Fill me with your spirit. I want to be who you've called me to be. I believe in you. That's what God calls us to. That's what he calls every single one of us. And if you haven't done that, I encourage you to just pray that prayer. It doesn't have to be specific words, but it's the heart of saying, God, I confess my sins to you. Forgive me. I want to give them over to you. I can't handle them on my own. And I want you to fill me with your spirit. I believe in you. I want to live as you always called me to live, which is in relationship with you, sharing that love that you've so readily bestowed upon me to others. That's what he calls us to. The old is gone. You're becoming more and more who you were always created to be. That's what he wants to offer you. And here's a crazy thing. This Christmas, believe it or not, Lucasfilm, the people who created Star Wars, they revisit the idea of the Star Wars holiday special. You may have seen this, it's on Disney Plus. It's the Lego version. And you know what? It's pretty good. It's actually really funny. They redeemed the past. They owned it, didn't try to hide it, and said, and redeemed it, and made something beautiful out of it. And that is what God wants to do with your life. But you have to give it over to him. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you. Lord, that we can't handle our sin on our own, and that you don't call us to. And Lord, I pray each and every single one of us, Lord, help us not to try to handle our sin on our own. Help us not to try to hide it, Lord, but confess it to you, give it over to you. And Lord, to invite you into our lives, to be in relationship with you and to believe in you and to live free from the bondage of sin, and live in the hope and the redemption of you. Lord, if someone who's watching this has never prayed that prayer, I pray they do that right now. Lord, thank you for the hope, for the grace and the love that you offer every single one of us, and we get to share that with others. So Lord, we pray that we live in that belief, we live in that hope and relationship in you. And it's in your holy and divine name we pray, amen. Well, before we go, I want to remind you that you matter, you belong, and God has a purpose for your life. Until next week, see ya.